Hello and welcome. So you saw all these awesome looking skins, as Ravenfield calls them, and now you want to make your own. This video will show you how. Before you start watching, make sure to bookmark this video so you can return to it later. Just call this bookmark whatever you would use to search for this video. For example, skin Ravenfield, or make new character Ravenfield, or RF. Anything that you will enter in here to try to find it, use that to make this bookmark, and then you can easily return to this video because you might have to stop and come back later. Alright, so what you do is you go to the Ravenfield modding website. There is ravenfieldgame.com/modding.html. Link is in the description of this video. On desktop you have to scroll down and press the show more button and you will see the whole description. On mobile you have to press the arrow next to the title and you will see the description below. And down here you find Ravenfield Tools Pack. Currently you need to get the beta branch of the Ravenfield Tools Pack, so click this. Click the download icon and wait. Then you gotta right click the zip file and press extract all. And confirm and wait again. I recommend you rename the folder to my skin or something like that. Go inside, copy the path, and then in Unity you gotta open that path. Warning, in this video I will first try using 2018 and then 2017. Many steps will work, but then later steps will not work. You need to use the version indicated on the website, which is 5.6.3p1. I will show you what happens if you use the wrong version, and then I will correct myself step by step. But if you don't want to have to deal with all that, make sure you get the right version from the start. And then in Unity you gotta open that path, just paste it in here, and press enter, and press select folder. You will get this warning, just continue. And now you have to wait once more. Alright, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to assets, and then we're gonna go to content. And here we have example skin content mod. If you can't exactly read what it says, you can use this slider down here to make it, I suggest you use the list view. We have example skin content mod, example vehicle content mod, and example weapon content mod. We want skin content mod, so we're gonna just make a copy by holding down the control key on the keyboard and clicking and dragging the example skin content mod and releasing. And now we're gonna rename this to my skin mod. You can change that later. And if you look on the right hand side, we have a few things we need to configure. We can just open these up. We have to set the mesh for soldier, mesh for hands, mesh for foot. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna just pick random other 3D models. Just to be able to test it. This will not make sense, but let's just give it a try. And we can change the name here and let's call this nonsense. Alright, while the My Skin mod is selected, we need to go to Ravenfield Tools and Export Map or Content Mod. We can also press Ctrl E. Alright, we will just use the latest version, notwithstanding this warning, and then we get this completion message. If you for some reason want to move the file directly, it is in your Ravenfield installation folder, /mods, Ravenfield Tools Export, and then the name of a file, My Skin mod. Which is also the reason why you definitely should not leave this called My Skin mod. You should add your username, for example, like that, or else there might be conflicts later with other mods, so make sure to change this. Okay, so now that I changed that, it's probably gonna export again. Anyways, I want to test this, so let's just go to Ravenfield Tools, Test Map or Content Mod. We can also use Ctrl T. Okay, so in this case you don't get inside the map immediately, you have to actually go to Instant Action, and then here with character skins you gotta pick the one. Nonsense. Anyways, let's give it a try. Okay, so this clearly did not work. So when you use the correct version of Unity, it should actually not look that crazy. Here's what it should look like. Okay, you can see some weird mesh there. Yep. That is us. And that is other people. So this is how enemies and teammates will look like if you use some random meshes instead of character meshes. So, if you use the right version of Unity, you will get results, but these results just make no freaking sense. And if you use the wrong version, you get this weird glitchy thing that I saw earlier. First, I'm gonna go to the Ravenfield data folder, and in here in mods, in Ravenfield tools export, I'm gonna delete these two, so that we only have one nonsense mod later on. Alright, so if we click on example skin content mod, we can see which models were used originally. Soldier. If we click on it once here, we can see it's the soldier mesh and the soldier blend file in the character folder in models in assets. So what we're going to do is we're going to make a copy of this. So hold down the control key on the keyboard, drag and release. This is going to take a little, and we're going to rename this to my skin model. If we go back to content, click on example skin content mod, we can see hands and kick foot. They are also in models. So we're going to also make copies of hands no IK for custom models. Going to drag it here, and we're going to make a copy of kick foot. So we're going to rename this one to my skin hands model, and this one to my skin kick foot model. Just to make it easier for us, we're going to move these three by shift selecting them together. We're going to move them to the content folder. In the content folder, here we have the files. And what we're going to do is we're going to just edit the character model, which is my skin model. I'm just double clicking it, and here we have it open in Blender. I'm going to go to default, just going to join this area so we have a little more space. I'm going to press T and N to have a better look. And in this video, we're not going to create a new model from scratch. Instead, we're going to use an existing model. In my case, I extracted the advisor from Unity, from Ravenfield. You know, this advisor from that sequence in Ravenfield. I'm just going to copy the path here. And in Blender, I'm going to go to File, Import, Wavefront OBJ. And I'm going to paste the path in here. And go to Advisor and select the advisor and double click it. In this case, we have a perfect match because it was made for Ravenfield's skeleton. So now I just gotta remove the old soldier. All right, so we can just right click the soldier over here in armature and delete, and he's gone. Now I'm gonna have to select the advisor and then shift select the bones. And now we're gonna have to hit Control P, and we're gonna pick armature deform with automatic weights. All right, if we click on the skeleton now, and Control Tab, we can right click them and rotate them, and it seems to have worked. Oh, not the face though, not the face. Okay, I'm just gonna keep testing. This seems to be all fine. Just gonna have to fix the face. So we're gonna select this bone, and then in weight paint mode, I'm just gonna press T and set this to max and paint this, and then zoom in, set this to a bit less and paint these. Wait, no, a bit more. Okay, let's test again. Okay, now it seems to be working fine. All right, so that was okay. Okay, so the mesh is already renamed. That's good. I'm just going to call it advisor without the zero. I'm going to go to File, Save. And now in iwanPlays My Skin mod, I'm going to select the advisor body. So in Character Skin Mesh, I'm going to click on this circle. And I also can use the search area. Adv. Okay, that doesn't work. What's going on here? Let's open up the My Skin model. Still has soldier, so maybe I have to refresh. I don't know why that had to be done, but all right. So now let's go back to iwanPlays My Skin mod. I can actually drag this advisor mesh in here, but I can also just select it here. And as for the arm skin, we're gonna use the defaults to be lazy. So hands model, hands we're gonna drag in here. And for the kick leg skin, we're gonna just use My Skin kick foot model. And kick foot is going to get dragged in here. Remember, you have to have this, in my case, iwanPlays My Skin mod selected for this. Okay, so now let's see. This is probably not going to work well with the texture of the character. Materials are set to actor blue, actor blue, actor blue. We're just going to test it anyways. I'm just going to rename this to advisor, even though this one is still called differently. Remember, you need to use your username in the mod name, or else you might have conflicts with other people's mods. Like if you call yours Fortnite, then you're going to have 2000 conflicts. Har har. All right, Ravenfield tools and test map or content mod. And let's just wait for it to compile. Oh no. Oh no. Alright, so the problem was apparently that I was using two new Unity version, 2018.1.1.F1. Don't do that. A 5.6 version is recommended. I think 2017.3.1.F1 also worked. Alright, let's hope this works. And it does. And the mouth is screwed up and the eyes are because the skin is the wrong one, but let's just try it real quick. Look at our custom skin, everybody. Ain't that nice? We're just gonna have to fix the mouth and the textures. And here's the enemy team. This looks really weird with the mouth and the eyes. So I happen to have the textures prepared. Let's just drag them in. Alright, so here we have these images, but we need to turn them into materials, weirdly. So let's right-click on the gray area and go to Create Material. And let's call this Adv Blue. And now we click on Adv Blue and drag Advisor Blue right into the Albedo box in here. Let's make a copy of this. Adv ADV red. And we're gonna drag the red texture in here. And now in our iwanPlays my skin mod, we're gonna drag Adv blue in here. Let's test this with Control T, and it doesn't quite work yet. If we drag in the model in here and drag the texture on the advisor model. So the reason why the mouth and eyes weren't showing is because T material was set to 0, which means the 0th, which means the first material would be replaced by the team color. I'm just gonna change this to 1, so nothing is affected. But this is not gonna work again because we use the wrong version. Yeah, it doesn't work, it just doesn't work. As cool as it is, it does not work. Alright, this time subscribe. We're in Unity 5.6.3p1. Alright, so now let's select iwanPlays, my skin mod, team material. Let's just go to Ravenfield Tools and test map or content mod. It works. It is working. Okay, so nobody in particular explained it to me. If we are cool with using the default color material, which we can find in materials, actor blue and red, or actor blue, actor red, then we can have one character in the mod, one skin in the mod, size 1, and it will automatically switch colors. But if you want to have extra features as part of the main texture, like eyes and mouth, because I couldn't figure out how to use separate textures for that, then it has to be separate ones. So we're gonna have to use two skins. So it's gonna be Advisor Blue and Advisor Red. And we're gonna have to pick character skin. Mesh is the same, but the material is gonna be blue there and red here. As for hands, that doesn't really matter. Alright, so we have Advisor Blue and Advisor Red. Okay, looks fine. If we use reverse colors, we will probably be... Yeah, we will have red teammates, but we ourselves will have a blue skin, that's right. And the blood is also blue. Alright, so we can fix that by just setting team material to 1 here. And also I fixed all the materials, so the Advisor Red has only Advisor Red materials and Advisor Blue has only Advisor Blue materials. And also I set team material to 1, anything but 0, so element 0 does not get replaced by the team color. Also it turned out that my materials are incompatible with the leg and arm UV textures, so I'm just gonna use Actor Blue, Actor Red, the default ones, since I'm using the default arms and legs anyways. Okay, this is working fine. The blood color is still different, so that's a thing. Maybe in the future we can also change blood and flag color. So look out, check the comment, check out the top comment, or check out the video description. On desktop you have to scroll down and press the Show More button and you will see the whole description. On mobile you have to press the arrow next to the title and you will see the description below. Check out the video description for updates by me. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to create a character using a model you find online. Still not from scratch, but also not from a model specifically made for Ravenfield. I will also show you how to upload it to Steam Workshop. The link I will add to the description and to the top comment. And in general, subscribe if you haven't yet. I will see you then. Ciao!